because I'd been in New York all the time. And he brought Charlie Parker in this hotel room in the Booker Washington Hotel.
There was nothing to do but play, you know, and we had a lot of fun trying to play.
Right after that, man, Charlie Parker was mine.
That was the first time I ever had the pleasure to meet Dizzy Gillespie.
And then remember Miles.
Miles was in my original band.
And Charlie Parker created the style. And the moment I heard him, I said, that's how music should sound.
A tribute to the Birdman, the father of Birdland, a masterpiece, a release, the horns, words, and the musical great salute, the late mentor, inventor of the sound that dates back from bebop to pop and pop to hip-hop. We fuse the times of jazz and rhymes and got Kumo D and Big Daddy Kane to bring on the legends. Kane hit the name.
I kick a rap too, but you can relax too. A jazz soloist play away with the sax to get the job done, the next one up to do his duty. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. James Moody. No one goes the mile like Miles Davis. Watch how he plays this trumpet and pump it just like a mechanic handles a tool. Here's the rebirth of the cool. What kind of noise can a string bring, making it swing and sing things of a musical fling? Well, listen to this star. Next up is George Benson bringing a guitar. Voice of choice used just like an instrument. So magnificent, I'm proud to present Devon Sassio, aka Sarah Vaughan. Honey, you're on. I'm introducing a bop revolution in jazz that has bazazz. He has one player using it. Ask who is he? First name Dizzy. Last name Gillespie. Now watch him get busy. Allow me to tell a story about Ella Fitzgerald, whose sound can never be sterile. A woman with flexibility of range, making octaves change. Go ahead and do your thing. This is a shout out to one more man, Joe Zawinul, the writer of Birdland.